and a very good morning to all of you present over here, all our chief dignitaries, the minister who will be also joining us shortly, Dr. H.P. Kumar, Mr. Mahendra Swaroop, Mr. Vishwanath from PhD Chamber of Commerce, and a very good morning to all the entrepreneurs over here. Are you with me? Good morning.
Yeah.
Good morning to all of you. You know, I'll actually start this with a small story that I can now recall, and you know, whenever this particular show comes for me, you know, I always normally try to go down the memory lane and see how entrepreneurship has emerged over the years. I can recall, and in fact, there were quite a few incidences which happened in those days, and the word entrepreneur used to be very heavy back in 2004 or 2005, and it was my early days of journalism and franchising world and franchise India. And I recall meeting, there was this Supreme Court, very senior lawyer, and he had these three sons whom I incidentally met at that time. He was doing some big deal, and I happened to have an interview with him, and his sons met me. So one of his sons was a doctor, and he was proudly telling me that this son is a doctor, and he's, you know, going, he studied from overseas, and he's going to be at AIMS, one of the senior department. And then the second son came in, who was just about to become an IAS officer. And then the third son came in, and apparently, you know, he was very reluctant to introduce me to him. And, you know, the guy also didn't really pick up his head. And I said, what does he do? He says, he's doing his own work, so we'll see where it goes. You know, so I could almost tell that there was not a lot of pride that he was giving to me when he was introducing the third son to me. And while Franchise India really stands all for entrepreneurship, I tried to talk a little more to him, but it seemed to me that he was more in awe of his brothers and his father maybe, and didn't really open up to me at all. So, you know, I think at that time, particularly those early years of 2000, it was more about, you know, job security was the whole foundation of what Indian, you know, Indian career or businesses, businesses was probably a bad word at that time, you know. So if you were a businessman, you probably could not find anything else to do, and that's why you became a businessman. So job security was very, very high. But, you know, thankfully, we're now coming into an era where this job security has lost its meaning, or it is slowly dwindling, and people are now looking to become, or, you know, explore the opportunities which they always have at the back of their mind. And, you know, they want to kind of give it, even when they're working, they're always thinking that, you know, when am I going to start my own business venture? So times have changed, you know. Sahej, are you there? Can you just stand up? Okay, she's a young student, about 16 years old, and she's a daughter of a friend. And she came up to me last week and said, you know, I'm about to pass out and I'm going to do a course on entrepreneurship. So you please guide me on what to do. When I see such young people walking up to me and telling me that, ladies and gentlemen, I can tell you one thing. Entrepreneurship has arrived. And that is a real big deal in this country. So I think it's to all of you who have changed in this country and come forward to learn or celebrate entrepreneurship at this very show. So big hand to all of you over here. So, as I said, Sahej is one example, but the whole socio-economic fabric of this country is completely changing. People are looking to explore opportunities. They're looking to get into products and services which were probably, you know, probably there, but nobody wanted to get into them. And I think the fact that they're able to, you know, there's a large tolerance which I have seen for any sort of political, economic, social challenge which comes in the way of an entrepreneur. He's ready to take it on him. He doesn't care, you know, and it does not deter him to stop on his way of putting up a large enterprise. And the fact that he's able to deploy people, funds, create value is amazing. And I think that is the value that he creates is really what is generating the real happiness to him in terms of building enterprises. And that is the call of entrepreneurship that is happening. So we are gonna have some policy makers present over here today, and you know, my only urge to them would be that they need to see entrepreneurship more as a process and not an individual act. And the policies that they frame, anything that they do towards encouraging entrepreneurship needs to be done on the lines where the whole ecosystem of entrepreneurship grows. You know, one of the most celebrated ministries in UK is, and perhaps one of the most sought after ministries in UK is the BIS ministry, which is Business Innovation and Skills. And I'm very glad to share with you that The Modi government has actually started a new ministry, which is the Ministry of Youth, Skill Development and Entrepreneurship in India also. And I'm very sure it has been done with the thought that entrepreneurship needs to be encouraged in the country. So I can tell you folks that the government is thinking on the very right lines over here, and that is really the change we want to see happening. You know, I don't know whether some of you who might follow the business dailies, 2 days back I was seeing this very interesting article, which was there was a picture of Kishore Biyani, and then next to him there was a picture of the Flipkart founders, which was Sachin and Vinny Bansal, and both of them were talking to each other, the young fellows. You know, and I am the editor of this magazine, Retailer, and for many years I've been talking about what Kishore Biyani has been doing and what he's managed to achieve in such a short time in terms of retail and putting up such a huge retail character. And then in the blink of an eye, in the last 4 years, you see the Flipkart founders who probably made a company which is the size of, 5 times the size of the Future Group, which is Mr. Kishore Biyani's company. So that is the entrepreneurship this forum is all about. That is the entrepreneurship which this forum will promote. You know, it gives me such great joy to share that, people like the early days, the founders of Snapdeal, Zomato, they've all spoken and shared their thoughts and ideas at this very forum. And I'm very sure that the experts and some of you would probably be the next big league of entrepreneurs which will take out from this very forum itself. So, interestingly, I kind of, as I said, like to go back in history, and I was seeing that in the last 1800 years, in 1800 years, things used to probably move in the same way. There was more people used to live in rural areas, food used to be the same. And in the last 200 years, a lot of things changed. We started flying, we started calling people, we started going out and eating. And in the last 20 years, they've changed even more so. You now don't talk on landlines, you talk on mobiles. So the world around us is changing very, very fast. So I think the next 3 to 5 years, you'll see things, what you knew about way things were done and the things will be done would be again very different. So our pace of innovation has become very, very strong, not just in India, but across the world. And everybody needs to catch up with it. Now that while I was at Flipkart, many of you might actually know that sometimes you don't really have to be an innovator to become an entrepreneur. Ladies and gentlemen, the Flipkart founders actually worked at Amazon, and that is the company they created when they came back to India. That is the beauty of it. Entrepreneur is really not, he is by definition neither an inventor, he is not an executor, he is just the guy in the middle. And it's a French definition, one of perhaps the most important definitions of entrepreneur, that he is the guy in the middle who knows when an idea has a certain consumer, and he knows how to put together a team to take that idea or that product or service to the consumer. So he is the guy who gets fun in building enterprises. And that is what entrepreneurship is really all about. You have to have, and I think all of you who are present over here today, need to have all the right fun in building value, building a business, and taking it, making it big in the coming times. I could probably go on and on, but I think that is not the objective. So I'll probably share this one last thing with you, which is a special initiative that we've taken for this show. You know, I was 3 years back, I was in a certain entrepreneurship forum in Singapore, and an interesting thing that they shared with me was that if entrepreneurship has to grow, then money has to follow talent. But what I have always seen in India is that the talent has followed money. I see entrepreneurs moving up and down, right, left and center, trying to find out who could be the right bank, the investor, who could actually put money in their project, because they think the project is worth so much more. I'm very proud to share with all of you that at Entrepreneur India 2014, we've taken this initiative for the very first time to open a pitch room. And the pitch room would be, have about 20 top most investors of India who would actually talk to entrepreneurs about their business plans in much detail and see how fundable those businesses are in the coming times. So so that is really the beauty of the pitch room, that it has again, what I thought and what I recognized, the way the world works, is money has to follow talent, and talented entrepreneurs will actually end up talking to investors at the pitch room. We'll start the pitch room at about 11:30, 12. So anybody who has got investable business plans, great startup which could grow, please feel free to talk to the investors at the pitch room. I also thank IBCA for extending their support to us in helping putting together the pitch room. And thank you, Mr. Swaroop, for looking at this visionary thought right now. It is small, but I'm sure, very sure it will grow much bigger in the coming times. To end this, I would once again welcome all of you, and the Minister, Minister Sudarshan is also there. So thank you very much, Shri Sudarshan Bhagat, who is the Minister of State for Social Justice and Empowerment, Government of India, for joining us, sir. And to end this, I would say that this show is really all about you. It's all about you as entrepreneurs who are going to make the maximum out of it. So, you know, please feel free to ask all the questions that you have, all the ideas or insights that you have with our experts, and also liberally interact with each other, because I think this is the room, this is the place where the next set of big Indian entrepreneurs will be born. So welcome once again, and I wish you a great two-day session. Please feel free to make the most of it, and also visit the pitch room. Thank you very much, and welcome once again.